too flat, it's gone long of the back line. Well, Gracia Polly says that it hit her.
3-5.
Well, of course, if it did hit Suetsuna, hit her clothing, hit her body, then it would have been a fault, but the umpire says he didn't see it. But I have to say, looking at that again, it did look as if the shuttle may have been deflected, which would indicate that it did hit her. Oh, sadly, gone are the days in sport when players own up to a misdemeanour.
Out. Seven over. 6-4.
Wasted opportunity.
Serving over.
Seemed to rush
five,
that serve.
6.
Oh, that's a good return. The best of those serves from Maeda.
Serving over. 7-5.
Long.
Serve is over. 6-7.
Well, the crowd just came to get on the back of Suetsuna. She was serving. I didn't like the fact that they think that she may have faltered by the chance of touching her before it went out. And a little look from Gracia Polly.
8-6.
After winning that rally. In psychological factors. And a little look towards her opponent. Spent volumes without actually having to verbalise. Nice angle.
6.
Of course, Johari has been in a semi-final of this tournament before. That was back in 2008 when she used to play with Shindi Puspa Irawaki. Japanese pair that they're more than happy just to spend the early stages of matches really working their opponents by lifts and more lifts.
And
it's a 5-point advantage to Gracia Polly and Miniana Johari in the mid-game interval. Just 6 minutes of play. Were there. Rather than moving quickly, I think there was some instruction about the serve. Just to
16-6.
Dive the shuttle over the net. I think it you should ever think about hitting a low serve. Instead of hitting it, you want to think of just caressing the shuttle over the net, push through. That's great. Super play from Gracie Polly.
1-6.
Now, I've said it on previous occasions with this Japanese pair, they're so good in their defence, but when they get in the attacking formation, in other words, one hitting from the back of the court, the other at the net, never feel that the net player really hunts the shuttle enough. There's another excellent
13,
attacking shot.
Six.
The cross court drop. Getting a little bit impatient, but see it sooner. Talking to a partner, I'm not getting ready to play on.
Jamie Nova, 7-14.
Oh, that's good. Beautiful rally. Oh, as far as the Indonesians were concerned, it was all worth it in the end.
15-7.
Oh, some big gulps of air going in there. Working hard. Hot, humid conditions here in Jakarta. signs to me that already the Indonesians are feeling the pace of this. Having concluded this opening game. And the kind of work rate they put in so far. Spending a little more time willing to defend and not all out attack when they do get the couple in the air. Softer smashes.
Serve is over. Turn 16.
Changed or not. Got a bit of a cushion. Yeah, but they really did feel the pace of that round, didn't they? All four players taking the opportunity to tail down, take on board some liquid. And the umpire just trying to get the attention of the court attendant to come on and mop up the perspiration.
Liliana, shuttle please. Thank you. Grecia. 18-13.
3 points away from the first ever game. Oh, they're on a mat against this Japanese pair.
19-13.
Territory, because that's the first ever game that the Indonesians have taken against Maeda and Suetsuna. And this is how they did it. And the big question is, can they keep that going? For a second game, I have to say they were so positive from the start of the match. Thoroughly deserved it.
For 120 seconds. Miki, could you put inside? Grisha, you serving. Please on court. Please on court. Yes. Miyuki.
Well, the umpire organising the players, telling them to clear up their kit bags and make it all neat and tidy. Bringing them back on court.
Miliana. Second game. Level. Play.
And the Indonesians. In the first game, 21-13. Now they're playing with the wind, so the attacking play should be even more effective.
One,
the most important thing is to keep doing that, to keep looking for the open spaces. And coach Park Jibong on the left is really looking very concerned indeed.
Service over. One, all. Yes, quickly.
And they got caught in no man's land. Both the Indonesian players, Gracia Poli, had backed off from the net, but our partner had a Super Series event. There's two semi-finals in ordinary Super Series. 2010 in Singapore and last year in India. Thank you. cracking play.
Service over, 5-6.
That's clever smash, but that landed well in. Very awkward looking defensive shot there from Emiliana Giocari.
7-5.
The ceiling was good. That's going from left to right. Keeping the shuttle in. Oh my goodness!
Charlie Silva, 6-7.
Well, having got the first one back, then played one while she was sitting on the floor. Didn't manage it a second time, though. Did awfully well now. And she gets another one back. Second time of asking, makes the error. Certainly can't accuse this Indonesian pair of lacking effort, can you?
Yuki.
Wonderful rally. I just sense during that rally there was a little more urgency in the style of play from the Japanese pair.
6-7.
Looking to command the rally more, looking to be more positive. Badminton.
8-6.
James Peer is really now hunting the shuttle and looking for the opportunity to attack, get one of their players here to the left, which is the standard attacking formation. And two players standing side by side on the court, that's the defensive formation of the Japanese pair at the moment. Ah, now that's good anticipation. And see it sooner.
Serve is over. 7-8. Out. Serve is over. 9-7.
On service line is the only line that the umpire calls. The standard practice within the match, and the out you heard was coming from the umpire. Umpire Chiappini of Italy. And it's been all right. He's going with the drift, it takes it even further out.
Service over. 8-9.
Committed and back on defence, therefore aiming towards her right hip. The mid-game interval, and the Indonesians have a two-point advantage.
Got 120 seconds.
Well, Park Jibong is definitely giving advice about some form of attack. There's something that you see, number 8 seeds. Didn't really do enough of in the opening game.
11-9.
Against the drift. Really difficult for them.
Serve is over. 10-13.
Anticipated by Gracia Poli. Forward she goes before she's even played the drop shot. And then that Newton game, she had a similar backhand kill. Made no mistake this time. This because that drop shot from Johari not crisp enough, giving Maeda the opportunity and the time to step in and play the kill.
Thank you.
have the feeling that the next two or three rallies are going to be absolutely critical in the outcome of this contest. Back on level terms. And the Rangers despite the Indonesian players. This quarter final for the right to play the number two seeds, the current
15,
champions,
13.
And the
number two, number three,
managing to keep their noses in front. Short.
Okay.
Harvey. Everyone's celebrating the mascots as well. What an effort to reach that. Got to put that out of their minds though.
18, 15.
Into the time. Oh,
service over. 16, 18.
Nerves getting for Gracia Poli. From Fortuna as well.
19,
16. And now, Indonesians, rising points. Away from not only the semi final, but the first ever victory over this Japanese pair. And that's one of the points they need. It is now 4 match points for the Indonesians. Coaches applaud, as indeed they should. A memorable victory for Emiliana Giuhari and Gracia Poli. 21-13, 21-16 in 43 minutes of play. Oh, what excitement. Crowd absolutely loving it. We've still got another 6 matches to come today on quarterfinals day. Memorable moments. So there you can see confirmation that they'll play against the current All England champions, number two seeds, Tian Chen and Yao Yunlei of China, in tomorrow's semi-final. New experience for Gracie Apolli, first ever semi-final in her home event. You can see right at the top of the draw that Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang, the current world champions, will walk over in their quarterfinal against Matsuo and Naito of Japan, number six seeds. I understand that it was an injury problem right at the end of the Japanese match late yesterday evening. Able to play today. Well, that's the state of women's doubles, and that's the state of where we've got to in today's quarterfinal lineup. Well, it's men's doubles next.